saina oni ti nimunai amineskunda inaule o saina oni ti nimunai amineskunda inaule。
各位观众大家好，欢迎收看东海岸之声，我是达鲁巴潘仁王文斌。我们大家提到关岛呢，一般呢大家印象深刻是一个度假的一个地方，非常美丽的海景，甚至另外一个呢是美国非常重要在这个太平洋地区的一个基地啦。但是呢，关岛除了这些我们印象深刻之外，其实让我们世界南岛的一个角度来看的话呢，它跟我们台湾的原住民呢是有相当的一些关联性的例如在岛上的查莫洛的文化跟我们台湾原住民南岛民族呢都有非常相似的文化了。那我们这一次呢透过我们史前文化博物馆还有卡达文化工作室邀请我们查莫洛文化的几位工作的伙伴们呢来到台湾，就以椰子这个 mother tree就是椰子树呢为什么在他们关岛椰子这个植物占了这么大的一个文化的一个意义然后呢跟我们台湾原住民的植物或者是文化有什么一些关联性呢，能不能把它给这个连接起来这个工作方呢是非常具有意义的了好，当然我们也都知道关岛呢到目前为止还是美国的一个殖民属地了那跟台湾原住民在这样子的一个政治或者是整个环境来讲呢有很多是很相似的，譬如文化的流失主权主题性呢也都掌握不在自己的族人的这个身上这跟台湾原住民呢都非常有类似的那这个都是我们今天邀请到的我们查莫洛的文化推动者呢，他们也把他们关岛的查莫洛的文化的现况跟我们观众朋友一起来分享了好，首先第一位呢我们要介绍的是目前呢在关岛大学任职的 Joseph Babauta。 好、
yes. My name is Joe Babauta. I'm from the village of Agate in Guam, and I'm a cultural practitioner, and also I teach elementary in the morning, and in the evening time I'm a professor at the University of Guam, and I specialize in weaving.
Okay, thank you. Very welcome. 好，第二位是我们的这个 Joseph Viloria。好，就跟我们的观众朋友问候一下。
My name is Joe Viloria from the village of Hmong Hmong. I am a cultural practitioner and I specialize in traditional fishing, warrior discipline, body ornamentation, and we are located up at the Sayankatura Chamorro Cultural Center where we provide education and perpetuation of the Chamorro culture.
Thank you.好，第三位呢，是我们Joe的brother
Yes, my brother.
Brother, yes. 我们的 Raymond Viloria.
Yes, sir. My name is Raymond Viloria. I'm from the village of Hmong Hmong, and I'm one of the local petitioners up in Sagakaturan Chamorro, as long as my brother Joe, and I specialize in traditional fishing, weaving, and hunting.
谢谢。好，第三位呢？第四位非常的特别这个外观看起来好像是从关岛来的，其实他是我们阿美族人哦，来自都立部落了这个当然父亲呢是美国人妈妈呢是我们都立的阿美族我们介绍我们阿尚，阿尚跟我们的观众朋友问候一下。
南无法基法伊萨利卡卡马布隆哈，吉阿尚公安那古提拉伊都立古尼亚勒阿古。大家好
我们阿尚的主语讲得这么好呢很流利好，那我们跟我们的来宾要分享他们的文化之前呢，我们先看一则我们的报道。
开训仪式，部落族人特别以阿美族传统举行祈福仪式，来自关岛的查莫洛族人也特别依查莫洛族吹号角来祈福。 世界南岛文化交流工作坊三位来自关岛的查摩洛族人以椰子树为主题，结合当地食材进行料理教学与编织创作，让学员实地感受查摩洛族人如何充分应用椰子树的不同部位，像是椰汁、椰奶或椰丝，发展出当地的特色料理手法。
And this particular workshop that we have in this cultural exchange, involving culinary and the mother tree, the coconut tree, is how can we provide information that will be helpful to the community, and how they can be proactive, and taking measures through the understanding.
怎么样从椰子？然后椰子怎么样在关岛作为被视为是生命树，是母亲树，然后透过他们查摩洛人对这些相关的知识文化体系，包括是编的、织的、煮的、运用的，然后来跟台湾做一个交流。
八天七夜的工作坊共有十多位部落族人跟工作坊人员参与交流学习。
我们阿美族有的时候会用他的枝干来做打落案的临时的那个梁柱，那还有它的叶子呢，也是拿来那个铺盖它的屋顶，跟它的那个椰子的枝干呢，拿来做蒸饭的马霍尔，哦，这一类的器皿其实有很多的雷同的地方。
因为像阿美族来说的话，可能就是编织或者是吃，然后但是他们对于这种驱蚊啊或者药用的话，是比较不一样特别的用途。所以就是可以学习一些不一样使用的一些想法。
世界南岛文化交流工作坊希望能打开大家对椰子料理的视野与味觉的经验，借由国际公益文化的交流活动，关注关岛跟台湾之间相关文化元素的应用。
好，欢迎回到我们节目的现场。那刚刚在我们的新闻的画面呢，还有我们在我们的摄影棚的这里呢，我们都有看到了。我们前面出现的海螺，可能要请教我们的宝宝党，海螺代表的意义，代表的意思，在我们关岛查摩洛的文化里面，它有什么样子的一个意涵吗？
Yeah, blowing of the kulu, which is a conch shell, we use normally toalert people in the village if there's any information that they need to know, storms, or even just an announcement to everybody in the village. But we also use it to in celebrations where we invite our spirits of the past and our local people to come and all come together as one. And that's one way of communication and clearing the people to all understand that there is a cultural togetherness as in one village and throughout the island.
Okay, thank you. 那这个是代表对天或是对海的一种敬畏，有这样子的一个意涵，也是是凝聚部落的一个号角声吗？他有提到这样子的一个一个文化上的一个意涵呐，哈。我们请教一下，就是我们的 Joe 这里哈，是什么样子的一个机缘可以到台湾啊？我知道，好像我们 Joe 好像已经来三次台湾了，
three times
三次到台湾来了。那这一次呢，是用Mother Tree 这样子的一个文化的工作意涵为。那所以呢，这样子的一个方式啊，对自己本身或是对关岛查摩洛的文化跟台湾的连结，他个人有什么样可以跟我们来这一次的一个经验？
Actually, during my second trip, I had the honor of being assisted by Kredekder from the Atta Beads studio, and During the seashell workshop, I was asked if I could make a chamorro dish utilizing the coconut and incorporating that in a dish. So we had gone to the East Coast looking for the brown coconut, and we had a difficult time finding even one because of maybe certain restrictions with the private owners of the mother tree. We came across a booth stand on the side of the road that was selling the young coconut. And I noticed that the people here on the East Coast was only drinking the juice from the young coconut and discarding the rest of the young meat or the green coconut. And because we had a hard time locating coconut to grade for a particular dish, I noticed there were so many coconut trees on the East Coast. And I also noticed that as I asked questions that the materials from the coconut tree was underused. So I decided that maybe it was a good idea to come together so we can provide more information and education as to how the people, especially of the East Coast, can benefit from the resources of the mother tree. Mm-hmm. And so soon after that, we decided with Kadekader that maybe it would be a great idea to do a cooking workshop, introducing the Chamorro cuisine under the meat category, the fish category, and so forth. So we decided, hey, you know, it'd be really great to put a program together, invite people that are interested in the culinary of the Chamorro people, where that not only that they would learn about food, but the resources of the coconut tree that would include also the weaving practice of the Chamorro people. So that is how this whole program began, and working with the sponsors, which includes, of course, the museum, Taitung Museum of Prehistory, and their interest and support, and of course, the cultural center here in Torque, you know, where we identified a great venue site along the beach, you know, that we enjoy. And with the participants, which includes about nine individuals in this program, we're able to come together to share the benefits of the mother tree. In the Chamorro culture, compared to, of course, here in Taiwan, we call the mother tree the tree of life. You know, it is a tree that we honor from a very young age, where we are educated about the importance of the coconut tree, the tree of life, and how we can utilize the material resource from the tree to identify with the use of utility, materials that can be used to construct homes, how it provides protection, medicinal remedies, of course, and just an array of uses that comes from the mother tree. So we felt that maybe it was an aspect of our culture that we can share here in Taiwan, where the people can benefit from. Mm-hmm. So after a while, we had like this great input and interest. And I really appreciate that the people here in Taiwan wanted to participate in such a program. And I believe it's wonderful, and I hope to continue the sharing of the mother tree in the future.
确实啊，从这个树啊，从植物上面呢，就可以看到有很多可以交流，甚至可能会找到有一些相似的一个文化在啊。那可能要请教瑞这边，就说在这一次的刚刚有提到料理嘛哈，料理这个，那我们知道这一次呢，好像有一个叫地窑炉啊哈。那从我们了解的地方，其实我们台湾原住民哈。目前呢，现在都还有会使用这样，像我们卢凯族，我们叫以祭米，以祭米就是在地上呢，我们就挖一个小坑啊，然后呢，食物放里面，把石头烧烫了之后呢，放里面，然后再用叶子盖起来啊，盖好了以后再用沙土呢盖起来，大概等了三个小时或四个小时的时候，回去呢就会把那个叶子打开，我们就可以来食用。是不是这样的一个概念？是不是在关岛也有哈？那这个地窑炉的制作啊，哈，它最主要它烹煮的食物是什么吗？这请教我们的瑞。
Normally, when we utilize the zhan, you can put in sweet potato, you could put in yams, you could put in fish, You could put in really even different type of meats and a variety of things. And it's an underground oven. And but you know, nowadays it's one of the best ways to cook because it's really, you get really all the flavors from the meats and the vegetable, and it's just a natural way of cooking, and I think it really tastes very good.
所以什么食物都可以了哈，对啊，它怎么制作呢？它怎么做这个地窑炉？
It depends on the amount of dishes you're going to put down in the zha'an. You could, there's a variety of sizes. You could make the hole and the depth. And you could use ginger leaf. You could use to cover up the vegetables or the yams you're going to cook because it gives flavor to the meat. But it depends what you're going to put in the zha'an. So it goes by the size of the hole.But normally the banana leaves gives a certain flavor and the ginger leaf gives a certain flavor. We also put the lemai leaf and even we wrap the potatoes in banana leaf, even the fish as well. You could wrap it in ginger leaf, but it gives a very distinctive taste. And the wood that we use too as well.
好，那这个呢跟我们卢凯族的一技呢非常的相似。那我们上面也是一样，会用那芋头叶哈盖住啊，这个跟我们哈几乎是一样的哈，这一样的。好，那我可能要回到巴宝达这边，我要请问巴宝达，就是刚刚我们提到了这个料理，那我们也知道巴宝达现在在关岛大学呢也任教，也在教导学生啊查莫洛的文化。那其中有一个呢啊，就是有关所谓的Latte Stone。啊，拉提斯东，拉提斯东在关岛有什么样子的意涵吗？啊，那我们从这样子的一个意义上面，跟我们台湾原住民有没有相似或相关联的地方
？There were a couple stones down in your area, in the Turk area. I just wondered about it because, you know, it looked bent a little, but you know, it looked like a shape of a latte stone.And with us in Guam, we use the latte stone. It symbolizes our past. It's like a mystery to us. You know, although the biggest latte stone you can find in Tinian, one of the smaller Micronesian islands, but in, you know, it stands up to 18 feet. You know, just showing that the latte stone to be that big, although, you know, there's only a couple that's standing in Tinian. Back in Guam, we have them up to 8 feet. We have two that have been measured at 8 feet. And to make you wonder how, even in ancient times, how were they able to put a pole, we call it haligi, which is a pole,And then you have tasa, which we call a cup. How were they able to get the cup on top of the haligi without no machinery? You know, it only tells us that our people, our islanders, were big and strong people. And I'm pretty sure around here, I haven't seen any big ones yet, but if I look around, I'll probably come across one thatWould look like a latte stone too.
好，这个就真的是跟南岛民族文化里面有真的是息息相关的一个文化。我们也有巨石的文化，尤其是在东海岸啊。好，我要回到阿尚马丁这里哈。你参与这一次的这个工作坊嘛哈？对你来讲的话，你所看到的这个交流上面的文化的意义呀、啊、哈？你怎么看？你跟我们分享一下，就是说关岛跟就以杜立部落或是台湾原住民你所知道的，那这里面有可以寻得到有一些蛛丝马迹吗？有很多很相似的吗？
因为其实我在这个工作坊的那个过程当中，其实都是幕后，我们都要像我们，尤其是我们的部落，我们负责的是主要是创造一个美好的一个学习的环境哦， 是让那些学员，然后尤其是三位老师哈，让他们像有自己的家的感觉哈。然后在那个他们在进行的时候，就常常会在旁边观察，然后偶尔会有我们的老人家都会偷偷的跑过来哦，他们会对他们好奇，他们在到底是哪里的人，然后啊，他们的语言怎么有啊，怎么像很多字也是有一点点像哈、哦，像他们待会的，他们有讲到什么像巴布伊，我们三柱叫法布伊，然后马达里马，其实那个好了，不只是关岛，那个是整个太平洋。是那些相似的，但是老人家会很好奇，然后从他们身上的话，他们像看到他们挖的贝壳，然后只要是看到那个线，其实我们老人家都会做制作这些线，他们看到他们的项链，然后他们都会用不同的材料哈，就有点我们的老人家就开始在想，哎，其实以前我们也有用这些材料啊，哦，好了，椰子树是没有，那个在都里的话，在这边东岸的话是后来引进来的，但是像。他的贝壳，他们是用那个我们叫 hilahil 哈，是那个黄锦，像那个黄锦树去做那个线哈。然后老人家也看了，哎、欸，对哈，以前我们的教法也是用这个 hilahil 去做，去绑这些竹子哈。像那个叶子编的话，原来有叶子的编法这么多，像阿美族的编法所知道的都是。重点是在使用，一定要是有容器嘛，盒子装东西，放东西。然后他们的，哎，怎么突然冒出来一个什么像蚱蜢，还有一个长得像那个螃蟹这样，就老人家就觉得很好玩，就是开始也会在后面偷偷的学。
好，非常谢谢阿尚哈。所以只参与其中呢，你就会哦从自己的部落的观点，还有自己所认识的文化呢，去观察到我们长没落的啊文化的一些关联性了哈。好啊，我们要休息一下哈。那我们要休息一下啊，待会呢，我们再来看看啊，关岛长没落文化呢，跟台湾原住民的文化之间呢，有哪些呢更相似的啊？尤其呢啊，他们总认为哈，兰屿呢跟啊这个长没落的文化好像有关联性哦。好，别离开。欢迎回到东海岸之声。那我们这次呢，啊，这个查莫洛的文化，就是关岛查莫洛呢，啊，透过文化啊工作方的这样子的交流，邀请到我们来自关岛查莫洛的族人，然后来到我们台湾。那这一次呢，啊，在东海岸的都立部落。那过程当中呢，刚刚我们的这个阿尚也提到哈，就是都立部落长期以来哈，也都做编织这样子的一个文化哈，就一直在做延续传承。所以您这次也都参加这一个工作坊嘛哈。可不可以分享啊？上分享一下这一次您所观察到，就从编织的角度哈，都立阿美族的部落跟我们关岛查莫洛的文化的编织方面有地方相似吗？或者是说啊，过去老人家我们都立的老人家都立老人家看到啊，有什么样子的一个火花产生啊？来分享一下。
那主要是因为其实编这些篮子是。月桃和那个椰子树的那个叶子，有些编法其实是相同的哈，很接近，哈。不过像在他们在编这个椰子的那个像篮子的过程当中，因为它的那个材料比较长，所以可以编出其他的样式哈。然后老人家看到这些样式是很喜欢，他们很想学，哈，因为他们的以前的编那些成品哦，那些篮子什么都是，重点是在它的用途是什么，哦，然后他们来了，他们也带来了，哎，另外概念其实有这个美学的概念，就这个椰子树的那个椰子哦，它可以编各式各样的东西，像我刚才讲，像那个宝宝的，它又编出来一只螃蟹、蚱蜢。鱼啊，爱心什么的，就是可以玩。然后老人家很喜欢这个，很稀奇，因为这个椰子叶哈，它编的多样性比那个我们自己在用的月桃还多，哦。然后相反是像他们 这三位老师哦，他们也对我们的乐陶也很有兴趣哦。主要是因为他们其实有乐陶在关岛是有的，但是他们其实没有使用它。
那我们眼前看到的这些就是他们带来的，还是这次工作坊啊编的啊？这个就是关岛长没落的编织吗？我们眼前看到的。
对，大概面前看到，对啊，都是啊，这个都是椰子。
我们眼前看到的这个部分是拿来装什么的吗
？That basket right there is
这个大的是做什么用的
？What's the big one?
It's used for fishermen take it out to put their fish in their catch, and although it can make the basket wider and you know more more smaller in height, you use it for other stuff too. Mainly though, women would weave for stuff that would be used in the house, at the home, and in the kitchen especially. But then the men would have to weave their baskets when they go out fishing.
Okay, 是男生使用的，然后呢，打鱼用的编织，然后那还有一个我感到很好奇的，这个会是什么？这个是扇子吗？还是打苍蝇的？啊，这是扇子。
Multi-use.
Well, 多元的使用。
Something like that today, we can shape it different shapes, and yes, before we use it to whenever the flames die out in the fire, we use it to start the fire back up and bring the flames up. But today now, we look at it as an art. Just like the harp that was at the center, the workshop center, it's the same weaving, same type of weaving with the harp that was there, but make it bigger. And also you can make it smaller too, different shapes.
Okay, oh, this art.
Now we use weaving as an art also.
Okay. Oh, 那这个很有趣啊。那这个是什么
？Yes. This is in the Chamorro culture we call this lomok.
Lomok.
Lomok. Yes. And it's a device to smash red peppers. It has multi uses. Of course, it's a device that is used in medicinal practices to incorporate oil.And other medicinal remedies such as leaves or ferns that we break down. There's a variety of medicines, and this is a very useful device to mash and mix.
Okay, 好，哦，非常有趣，谢谢，非常谢谢，哦，好，那这个，哦，这个是用什么东西做 ？Coco?
Yeah, this is from the coconut.These are the ladles we use if we make like a soup type of dish. You could scoop it out, whatever you cook, and you could pour it into your bowl to drink or to whatever meats to eat. And this comes from, we call this part the anigas of the coconut. So this is what we use normally for like soup dishes.
Oh, this is 喝汤哦。那也可以拿来喝酒吗？啊
？Yes, you can. Yes, you can use it as a drinking vessel as well. Yeah, but we normally
alcohol.
好，那我们眼前呢，大概都跟料理有关，然后那我可能再回到刚我们提到的蘭語的交流的这个部分啊，可能就请教我们的。Ray 这哈，所以就在这一次的蘭語的交流啊，你的观察啊，有没有观察到比较有趣跟查莫洛文化啊，还有你所看到的查莫洛文化跟蘭語达悟族的文化相似性的，可以跟我们分享吗
？Yes, when I was there in Lan Yu, a lot of the people really had my complexion as well. We're both dark, even the facial as well.And some of the kids there too say we look like their uncles, you know. And I see some of the similarities in the facial. Some of them look like Chamorros back in Guam. And Sometimes I think like I saw some of them that look like some of my cousin or my friends. Mm-hmm. And I was going to go up to one of them and say, what are you doing here? You're supposed to be in Guam.
Mm-hmm. Oh, like a brother.
Yeah, brother or sister.
Mm, yes. Oh, so he saw the 就是我们达悟的长相啊，就跟关岛的人的长相很相像了，很相似啊，哈，哦，还有肤色啊，这个，哦，好，好，非常谢谢。那从这次的交流过程当中，可能再请教就我这边哈，就是您看到的兰屿的渔猎的文化啊，它也有捕捉飞鱼，他们也有划这个啊，这个平板舟，我们叫平板舟啊。就这里您所观察到的啊，兰屿达悟族的不管是渔猎的文化，或是这个平板舟造船的这一方面的文化，你的观察有没有跟关岛长莫洛的文化有没有很相似的？
Of course, this is my second time on Orchid Island, and soon after arriving at the airport, we were taken around by Babu, a local friend of ours that resides in Orchid Island.And within just a couple of hours, we were invited down to the beach by some of Babu's friends, where we had sat down along the beach and enjoyed some sashimi and enjoyed the albagbang, you know, the flying fish, you know, and I was just, I think, taken aback by the hospitality of the people there.In regards to the seafaring practices, in fact, at the airport, I was looking at some of the images on the wall, whereby, being that it's the second time, my first trip there, I was very curious about their seafaring practices and what still exists in way of their traditions in regards to seafaring. Two trips before, the first trip, I had the opportunity to meet with one of the canoe carvers, and they talked about, you know, the sailing practices that there is a possibility that it was a practice that they had in prehistory. Looking at the design of the boats there and how they practice in the relationship to fishing,where they can just go out only so far and they're catching mahi-mahi, you know, flying fish. And I think it was very important to me to do further investigation about their seafaring practices and fishing practices, because in our Chamorro culture, the relationship with the Chamorro people and fishing for Yalibangbang has been lost for a very long time. And it is...Though we have the flying fish in Guam, I wanted to return to Guam where we can revitalize and reintroduce the practice of the flying fish. And that was one of the most insignificant part of my visit to Orchid Island. And, you know, trying to communicate with the local people there, trying to gather as much information as I could in regards to the flying fish practice.
非常谢谢，我们就他观察到了把兰屿的飞鱼文化跟海洋文化，甚至于呢到关岛的查莫洛啊，面临的都是同样都是岛屿的国家，好，把海洋的资源啊变成一个我们当地的文化上的一个跟来查莫洛跟达悟有很多相似，因为都是靠海了哈，非常的好，谢谢 ，OK， 好，那我们再。第四个问题要请教我们的这个爸爸的哈，那这次兰屿的交流的过程当中，针对语言，您的个人的发现观察哈啊，兰屿的达悟的语言啊，跟查莫洛的语言啊，有没有地方是极为相似的
？Well, first of all, I hear a lot of Tao, and I don't know where it is there in Orchid Island, or I don't know if that's just another name.But Tao in Chamorro means land.
Land.
Okay? Yeah. The word we use for land is Tao Nu.
Tao Nu.
But Tao itself is a small piece of land. Okay? Now when you put tau tau, I hear it's the same there in Lanyo. Tau tau means people. So, pretty much the same. We were going over body parts. I wanted to compare. They didn't have a word for eyebrows, which we call cejas, you know, but mata.
Mata.
Mata. It seems.
Me too. Yes. Look at mata.
Yes. Mata is a very common word for a lot of the islanders and also the other islands also throughout Micronesia and a few in Polynesia. But here I was surprised to see that even in Turik, when I was talking with the older folks, the elders, pretty much the same with a few of the people that I ran into and we're comparing. In Chamorro, we say talanga. Here, tangila.
Tangila, yes.
Tangila.
Look at talinga.
Same, just like Lanyo. You know, and just a few words that I was able to compare. I could only imagine that there was more, I'm pretty sure there's more that are very similar. And I'm glad I had the chance to go into the elementary school and the high school, because being that I work with elementary also, I was able to see that even the kids, they're still willing to learn. You know, and hopefully, through the sharing that we do, we can somehow help one another to bring our language back. Although it's going to be a hard task, but we can try our best.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Oh, thank you, professional.
Thank you.
谢谢。这个刚刚所提到的在兰屿的观察，确实我们从南岛民主国家呢所发现到，就是从语言的相似性呢建构了整个世界南岛的一个概念哦。那在台湾呢，保有目前官方呢有16族。如果照过去来讲，我们也把平埔族或是现在还没有证明的原住民族来讲的话，不止16族。那台湾呢，也被学者们公认为台湾还保有古南岛语言在台湾。所以呢，台湾是南岛文化的一个重镇啊，大家呢也都来台湾呢几乎来寻根一样哈，甚至在台湾看看能不能找到跟世界南岛有关的蛛丝马迹。所以呢，台湾这个原住民的语言呢，就占了一个非常重要的一个这个地理的一个位置了哈。好，那我们要休息一下，好，我们要休息一下呢。下一节呢，我们再来看在这样子的一个国家的政权，那现在的文化的流失，还有文化的推动、文化的复振这样子的一个工作，这两个同属在海岛的国家，它有什么样子的一个机缘，还有共同互相的学习这个地方呢，我们是不是下一节呢，我们再来分享他们的故事。欢迎回到东海岸之声的节目现场。好，趁这个机会，我们要赶快跟查莫洛跟台湾原住民的文化之间的关联性还有哪一些，我们赶快要把它给分享出来，要把它挖出来这样子了。好，那我想呢，可能要请教我们的瑞这里，就是针对台湾原住民也好，或是关岛原住民都有文化上慢慢有一些流失。那我们也知道瑞在关岛呢多做文化推动的工作哦。那你自己本身来讲的话，回关岛之后，你会怎么样子来推动自己的文化
？Well, we're at the Sagakaturan Chamorro in Guam, and I'm a local practitioner, and I do a lot of weaving, and I do a lot of hunting, fishing. I also mend nets, and I do teach there as well.So I have been continuing to teach, and it's not going to stop because we really love our culture, you know, and I want to keep it on. It's for the next generation, and I hope the next generation can realize and keep it alive.
以身作则哈，自己下去来做，然后也教导我们的后辈下一代哈， OK， 好，那我再请教我们的 Joe， 就这个我们也知道，你来台湾已经有三次的交流的这个经验了，那未来如果还有机会跟台湾再做交流，你最希望能够还有哪一些可以再更进一步的来促进查莫洛文化跟台湾原住民文化更进一步的文化交流，还有哪一些可以再更进一步的来做文化交流？
I think in the future, if there's any possibilities of a continued cultural exchange between Guam and Taiwan, I think I would like to focus in the area of traditional fishing practices. I think our relationship with the ocean is important.And I think to further share and educate about how can we protect our oceans for future fishing sustainability. I would like to really, really thank the sponsors involved in making such a program and a workshop possible. They've been gracious and open arms about looking at how we can share more specific beliefs.And practice on both sides, and I really believe both sides can benefit through education and perpetuation of both cultures, and how we can better identify our resources, whereby we can protect and conserve our resources as well. So yes, I'd like to thank again the community of Taiwan.for making this program possible.
Thank you, 非常的谢谢。那可能要请教我们爸爸打这里说，回到您自己的关岛大学里面以后，会怎么样子？按您现在来到台湾这样子的一个文化交流的工作坊的这个经验，回到关岛之后，怎么样子连结
？Okay, well, first of all, for the elementary level, I would like to let our students know that, it's practically the same with here in Taiwan, especially going over to Lanyo. I noticed that even the kids there, yes, they study, other subject areas, but I see that they speak a language that's not even home to them.And I didn't get much information as to what they're doing about Aboriginal language, but I would like to find out more and hopefully work together so that we can work our way up to reviving our language. As far as Taiwan itself, I'm sorry to say this, butJust like the land is a big mass of land, but it's just like Guam. It's only that Guam is smaller, Taiwan's a lot bigger, and so are the fruits and vegetables. The life itself, okay? Everything around us, I call my wife and say, you should see this. I see a flower that's bigger than my hand,Back in Guam, it's only like this. So I want to also do research on as far as soil and, what makes Taiwan bigger. And I would be happy to share that with my students, and hopefully they can also come and see for themselves, the adults. And again, language,We go through the same struggles, and I'm willing to share what I do, especially in elementary, because I see that in order for you to teach and the kids to learn, you gotta have fun doing it.
Thank you, Babata. 非常谢谢我们刚刚分享的这对自己查莫洛文化，他们我们感觉到他们都。有点使命感，就是那个使命感都在他们自己身上，而且甚至于呢，瑞也提到了以身作则，所以他们在不同的 工作岗位上面呢，他们对于自己的文化的复振推广上面呢，啊，非常不遗余力了哈。好，那最后呢，我们要做一点结语了哈，做一点结语。那可能就先从瑞这个地方。
Well, I really want to thank the people of Taiwan, Taitung, and even Orchid Island.I really had a lot of experience here, and there's a lot that I'm going to bring back with me, a lot of knowledge, and I hope that they learned a lot here too, and I hope that it can continue, and we try to keep our culture alive.
Okay, thank you. Joe?
I would also like to thank the people of Taiwan for their hospitality and all the support that's been given us.I love Taiwan. It's the key.
It's the key.
It's the key.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Hey, Baba Da.
I don't want to leave this out, okay? Heading down south, the coconut trees, very healthy. Abundance, many. But there is some areas that have been affected by the rhino beetle.Just like us in Guam, but in Guam, our coconut trees have been dying slowly, and I hope something can be done here in Taiwan to protect the rest that are still good. Okay, mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I hope I bring that, you know, to help everybody in Taiwan with the coconut trees. Mm-hmm. And for the most part, thank you all. This is my first time, and it will not be my last time.I will come back.
Oh, welcome. Welcome again.
谢谢。
Está aquí.
Está aquí.
好，谢谢。好，那我们阿桑。
感谢哦，尤其是感谢这三位老师哦。只要是像这种交流哦，我们人通常都要标注一个人是什么是什么，他是哪里人，他是哪里人。但是像有一天我们站在海边哦，我们就。一起吹这个骷髅然后就发现其实我们也是没有什么差别差不多是一样的人就是这个交像这种交流的活动非常的重要就是要是我们的想法是他们离我们好几千公里在外海那里但是其实透过我们自己原有的文化我们也是可以这样子踏出去然后跨到国际然后到国际的台面上其实不是说差别真的不大，我们真的是很像一家人哦。
好，非常谢谢我们来宾来到我们节目当中。其实我个人这一次的访谈当中从语言的角度来看的话，关岛在美国的殖民下学了英文，却没有办法把我们自己南岛语系、南岛民族的原有的这语言的相似性呢，在这个地方呢，很快的把它给建构起来。这也是我们目前呢，台湾跟南太平洋的南岛世界呢中间呢，还是要多加了一个语言的这个工具。所以这是我个人的一个很大的一个感触。所以呢，我们也期待在语言方面呢，我们要多更多的学习，甚至于呢，对自己的主语。主语的背后的意涵，主语后面代表的一个文化的一个意涵，这都是我们将来都彼此之间呢都要更大的一个努力的学习。好，今天呢非常的谢谢收看我们的节目，我们下次再会。